Welcome to Labor Law Lecture Series, Labor Laws Lecture Series. And in the first video, we started our discussion with the Trade Union Act 1926, and where we discussed the basic, like, historical concepts of a trade union. But in this video, we will discuss a bird's eye view of the Act, a bird's eye view of the Act, and then definition of a trade union. Okay, and in the subsequent videos we will discuss what are the other definitions, and then what are the funds available for trade union, amalgamation of a trade union, etc. But in this video we will discuss a bird's eye view of the Act and then trade union. Here is a bird's eye view of the Act. This Act was passed in 1926 under the title the Indian Trade Union Act, okay, and was brought into effect from 1st June 1927. This Act came into force from 1st June 1927. This Act is applicable to all over India. There is no exception to any states on this. The key objectives of the Acts are: one is to provide trade union and its members protection in respect of civil and criminal liability, and the second one is control of expenditure of funds for the specified purposes. Okay, these are the two objectives behind this. The first one is very clear, like in the first video we discussed that in the earlier times when any trade unions are formed, unions and the unionists were punished under various acts like restraint of trades or then conspiracy related rules. Okay, but now with the establishment of a Trade Union Act of 1926, trade unions got a recognition now, and the base, so the members and the trade unions are protected from the civil and criminal liabilities. Okay, and then the other important object is there will be a fund, right, which will be collected from which is going to be collected from the members, which is built based on the collections from its members, subscription from its members, that should be used for a specific purposes. It should not be used for unspecified purposes. So this we will discuss in detail when we discuss the sections of those. Okay, these are the objectives of the Act. And then on the right hand side you are saying the key definitions or a key sections of the Act. One is section 2, which deals with the key terms, definitions of a key terms. In this there are two important definitions which we are going to discuss. One is what is trade union, and the second one is what is trade dispute. Okay, there are many other definitions, but for this purpose, for the current study purpose, it is important to know trade union and trade dispute. And the second important part of the Act is registration sections, which are related to registration of an act and then cancellation of registration, etc., which are dealt in section 4 to 10. And the other important area is management of a fund, which is given in general fund and section 15 and 16. One is general fund and the second one is specified or a specific fund. Whatever we discussed here, right, these are key sections, but overall if we look into this Act, right, there are 5 chapters in this Act. Chapter 1 deals with is a preliminary part of the Act, which covers section 1 and section 2, majorly on a definition of a key terms. Chapter 2 deals with the registration of a trade union, and chapter 3 discusses with rights and liabilities of a registered trade union, and chapter 4 deals with the regulation, and chapter 5 deals with the penalties and procedure. Put together we have 33 sections in this act. Okay, with this brief background about the Trade Union Act 1926, let us discuss a definition of trade union, which is given in section 2H of the Act. Section 2H of the Act defines the term trade union as any combination, whether temporary or permanent, formed primarily for the purpose of regulating the relationship between workmen and employers, between workmen and workmen, or between employers and employers, for imposing restrictive condition on the conduct of any trade or business, and includes any federation, any federation of two or more trade unions. Okay, this little difficult and lengthier definition, but we will break this into four pieces, then it is very easy to understand. Okay, the first point, which is very important here, is it is a temporary or a permanent. Any association or any combination can be temporary or a permanent. It will also be called as trade union. It is not necessary that always it should be a permanent. Temporary means which is established for a specific purpose. After the accomplishment of specific purpose, the trade union will be get cancelled. But permanent means which is a long term. Okay, so the time duration of a combination is not important. Both are considered as trade union. Okay, and next, the primary purpose of the act is to regulating the relationship between the three combinations which they are given. One is workman and employer, and the second one is workman and workman, and the third one is employer and employer. Most of us are believe that trade union will be established by workers to fight with employers to get a better working conditions. Correct? We all believe that it is always set by a workman to fight against employer. But generally that is not only the case. Even this Trade Union Act recognizes if any union set up for the purpose of solving the disputes within the workmen, if there is any differences between the workman and workman, that will also be the unions can be set up for this particular purpose also. The other one is employer and employer. If there is a need for employers, like 3-4 employers in the same industry coming together and forming a body corporate or forming an association, that is also called as trade union. If 3-4 employers forms an association, that is also called as trade union. So it is a wrong notion that trade unions were always set by workmen. So even employers can also set their trade unions. Okay, so this is the second aspect of this definition. The third aspect of the definition is, what is the basic purpose here? Imposing restrictive condition on the conduct of any trade or business. See, if there is no act or if there is no laws, right, employer can play around the lives of workman. Okay, that's why there will be some restrictions on the conduct of a trade and or a business. So that is the third important point of this definition. And the fourth one is, any federation will also be called as trade union. In the first video, again, we discussed federation is nothing but it is a mother organization of multiple smaller trade unions. Trade union 1 year, trade union 2 year, trade union 3, trade union 4, right? All the four together, there will be a federation of trade union. It is a mother organization. In India, we have 12 such mother organizations which are recognized by ILO, or a federations which is recognized by International Labour Organization, which we discussed in the first video. A few examples are ITAC, Bharatiya Mazdoor Sabha, and others. Right? So the 4 points, I hope you are very clear. It can be a temporary or permanent. It is for the purpose of regulating the relationship between workman and employer, employer and employer. And the third point is for imposing restrictive condition on the conduct of any trade or business is objective, and it includes federation also, which is an association of two or more trade unions. I hope you are clear with the definition of a trade union. There are many other definitions given by sociologists and industrialists and others. I am not covering those definitions. You can refer some other books for those definitions. Here we discussed only a definition which is given by Trade Union Act. Okay, we discussed the definition. Let us look into a key cases and key items in this definition. Okay, we are aware that workman and employer always fight, and then there will be a trade unions to protect that. But here is some example for employee and employee. Okay, if there is a dispute between one employee against the other employee, and there is a loss or there is any loss suffered by other employee, right? These disputes can be handled by specific trade unions. And then also there is a employer and employer. Employers can also form the trade unions for their benefit. For example, we have seen, right, the oil manufacturing, oil extraction companies, they are countries, they are forming their group. Like we have a OPEC, okay, petroleum exporting organizations, right? This group will control the production of the oil based on the market price. If the market price is high, they produce high. If the market price is low, then they produce low. So they are the, this is the association of employers and employers. Many places, right, the employers can come together to not cut the prices or to make a production output based on the demand. For that purposes, employers can also form their trade unions. This was held in the case of Radha Krishna Jai Kishan Ginning and Pressing Factory versus Jamandas Nursery Ginning and Pressing Company Limited. This other case law here is Union of Employees of a Raj Bhavan. In Raj Bhavan, right, what we see, there are workers like maids, servants, drivers, etc. They cannot form any trade union. This was held in the case of Rangaswamy versus Registrar of Trade Union. The basic reason why it is not allowed is they are not into any trade or industry. I hope you guys are aware about what is trade and what is industry. Okay. And the other important case here is government servant performing sovereign functions. Sovereign function means the administration function where they govern the people of a country. Okay. And any government servant are performing sovereign functions on behalf of the government should not be associated themselves with a trade union. This was held in the case of Tamil Nadu NGO Union versus Registrar of Trade Union. The next one is trade union of employees of a non-commercial research establishment without profit motive could be registered as trade union. Okay. If any training institution, which is any research institution, generally research institutions motive will be non-for-profit. Okay, these are non-commercial entity. Even then, it is for non-commercial, non-profit motive, the employees of this kind of institution can form a trade union. This was held in the case of Central Machine Tool Institute versus Assistant Labor Commissioner. Okay, and the last one we are going to discuss today is a trade union is not an agency of a state. It's a very important point. Trade union is association which is going to be started by the employers or employees or a workman, right? It is not a government agency or a statutory body. There is no statutory powers to this unions. It is just a body corporate. It is a body corporate, but it is not a statutory body or it is not a agency of a state. This was held in the case of Chemosin Private Limited versus Krala Medical and Sales Representative Associations. Kerala Medical and Sales Representative Association. Okay, we discussed in brief about the act, structure of the act, and then we discussed in detail the definition of a trade union, and then key sections or key case studies related to definition of a trade union. Okay, before concluding this concluding this chapter, right, on the definitions of a trade union, let me highlight few roles of a trade union, which are very simple here. Like, I'm not going in detail explaining each and every point because these are very simple and straightforward lines. The basic role of a trade union is to secure the fair wages for workers, to improve working conditions, to secure employment tenure. It is nothing but we are seeing a layoff, retrenchments, right? So there should be a minimum layoffs, so that can be bargained only through trade unions. To enable growth of the employees by way of promotion, training, etc. To provide educational, recreational and cultural facilities. To protect the interest of the employees and family. And then finally, to promote individual and collective welfare. These are the roles of a trade union which play in the lives of a workman. With this, if you have any doubts or clarifications, please comment in the please question in the comment box below. That's it for now, and in the next video we will discuss about the trade dispute. Thank you.